Radio Disney, it's Candace. Welcome to the show. All right, so normally we would have the first caller contest right now. We're going to get to that a little bit later in the show today. That is because I have a special guest in the studio. Will you guys welcome Kat Cressida to Radio Disney? How are you?
I'm so good. It's so good to see you.
Good to see you. And for those of you who don't know, Kat is one of the voices you hear in Disneyland. You've done so many voices over the years, but tell us the big one that we are including in our sweepstakes on Instagram.
The Black Widow Bride.
That's so weird.
It is really weird, isn't it?
What if you just told this whole interview in that voice? Would that be weird for you?
It would be so weird.
Why?
Because it's a voice and because I'm talking to you and you're a homie and I would want to be me.
Yeah. We'll just do this, Kat. Hang on.
Here comes the bride. For better or for worse.
The Black Widow Bride is from the attraction at Disneyland. We all know it, the Haunted Mansion. How did you get this role of Constance on the attraction?
Serendipity and fate and awesomeness. I feel so lucky. And I try so hard to say that every awesome interview I'm lucky to do, because I was the little girl who kind of came from a little bit of legacy, you know, my father having worked with the WDI. So growing up in the parks and being the little girl, I used to sneak in a tape recorder just so that I could, when I got home, sort of reenact and imitate and impersonate. And I didn't know there was a thing called voiceover, but I loved the voices in the park. So that's kind of what I cut my teeth on, you know, growing up and loving to tell stories and read out loud from books. And a lot of people in Hollywood, you know, you do different careers. I was lucky enough to have an on-camera career, but realized that the on-set culture wasn't exactly my speed.
Gotcha.
And was so lucky to come into voiceover when I did, which was about 15 years ago. But I never thought in all of the times bringing people to the park, playing tour guide. I was a cast member for a while on Storybook Land, which was awesome.
Oh, cool.
I really thought that was as high as I was going to go on a voiceover gig, was running little canal boats. And to be invited into audition, they wouldn't tell us. They keep everything sort of, you know, very close to the vest because it's WDI. And
okay, what's WDI? We have so many acronyms at the Walt Disney Company.
I'm so sorry. Yes.
No, that's fine.
That's Walt Disney Imagineering.
Okay,
the amazing, you know, creators of all of the Disney parks' magic, so the attractions and everything. So
cool. When
you're brought in, you're just sort of given a couple of hints as to what it might be that they're going to be looking for in the first audition. And they were very vague. And then second, the callback was when they said, it might be for a classic attraction that you would know well. So, you know, obsessively went home and pulled out everything I could. And before the final callback, I did not sleep at all. I was cramming as much as I could about the mansion because they wanted a voice that would seem both classic and a part of it, so it wouldn't be jarring or, hey, what's this? But also contemporary enough that it would appeal to today's families and kids. And, you know, she was sassy. She's a little bit alluring. And what I was told was she's the voice that no man can resist. She's like a siren.
Totally. Well, hang out. We're going to talk more about the Haunted Mansion. Of course, our Instagram sweepstakes where you can win a chance to go on the Haunted Mansion with Kat. Check it out. Plus, we're going to get some inside secrets from the person who knows Disneyland better than anyone else I know. That's coming up next on Radio Disney.